A day after the cabinet reshuffle, you have new ministers taking charge of their respective ministries. The latest pictures coming in from the Union Health Ministry, where Mansukh Mandavia, the new Minister for Health, has taken charge. Well, it is going to be extremely interesting to see how this plays out, because Dr. Harshvardhan, who has been the health minister and, in fact, led the fight against the COVID-19 pandemic the last 1.5 years, was asked to step down. So in the middle of the COVID crisis, we have a new health minister there on your screens taking charge, Mansukh Mandavia. He is not a doctor by profession. He's one of those hard-bred politicians. Let's go right across to Sukirti, joining us with all the very latest. Sukirti, you cover the health ministry very closely. New minister, Mansukh Mandavia, taking charge. He has his task cut out for him, doesn't he?
Well, absolutely. While there are questions being raised on whether it is right to change a health minister in the middle of a pandemic, his predecessor's record has also been questioned in the past because of the handling of the pandemic and especially the second wave. And it is in very challenging circumstances that Mr. Mandavia has come in. He now has to ensure that we are all prepared to handle the third wave if it comes and also ramp up the speed of our vaccinations. And on that note, I would like to add that in the last 6 days, Mr. Mandavia has visited all the 3 production facilities, whether it's of the Serum Institute in Pune, whether it's a co-vaccine facility, which is in Ahmedabad. They have an MOU with Bharat Biotech. That is a co-vaccine facility in Ahmedabad, as well as the Zydus Cadila production facility in Ahmedabad. All of these production facilities of the 3 main vaccines have been visited by Mr. Mandavia in the last 6 days. So at that point of time, he was doing that in his capacity as the MOS for chemicals and fertilizers, which is the ministry he still retains. So he has already visited the production facilities of these vaccination sites. So at least he already has an assessment of what is the manufacturing capacity, what would the upcoming months be looking like in terms of how many vaccines India could get and whether we have enough to vaccinate our adult population by the end of this year, as the central government has promised. But that is only as far as the connection to his portfolio goes. Now, of course, other medical field connections also being drawn at this point of time. The fact that he has a degree in veterinary science from the Gujarat Agricultural University. He then later went on to do political science, but could, because of this connection to the medical field, is that something that could help him out? All of those questions are there, but of course, one is also looking at his political connections, which would have led to him being appointed as a minister in the cabinet this time, is that he has played a very crucial role in Gujarat politics. Even while Mr. Modi was the chief minister there, he has worked very closely with Mr. Mandavia, and that is why he is counted as one of Mr. Modi's favorites coming from Gujarat. So all of those connections at this point of time, but considering India has been among the worst affected countries because of coronavirus, and especially because of these challenges that are constantly coming up, whether it is the Delta variant and then the Delta Plus variant, and projections from experts that India could be expecting a third wave. So in all of these circumstances, Mr. Mandavia definitely has big challenges ahead of him. How he tackles those is a big question, and a lot of people now dragging out his old tweets and all of that. So he's already under the scanner at this point of time, because he was not, one would not expect that somebody without any connections to the medical field would make it as the Union Health Minister, considering his predecessor was a modern medicine doctor, Dr. Harshvardhan. So definitely there is going to be very close scrutiny of how he holds this charge, what are the first tasks that he chooses to focus on, especially in terms of ramping up vaccine production and all of these questions that we repeatedly see from states that they are running out of vaccines and there are vaccine shortages from states saying that center is not providing enough to us. So a lot of these things on his hand right now, and a lot to see on how he takes this charge.
All right, Sukirti. So Mansukh Mandavia, ex-MOS Ports, Shipping, Waterways and Chemicals, is India's new health minister in the midst of the COVID-19 crisis. A postgraduate in political science, 49-year-old Mandavia has been entrusted with the all-important portfolio of health. He's the Minister of Health and Family Welfare, also the Minister of Chemicals and Fertilizers. Here is one minister who has his task cut out for him and the entire country watching. Interestingly, Sukirti reporting that in the last 6 days, in his capacity as an MOS, he's already visited major manufacturing units for vaccines across India. Remember, ramping up vaccines is going to be perhaps one of the biggest and key challenges ahead for the minister. Thanks so much, Sukirti, for joining us with the very latest.